Hey, what's up YouTube? Before I start with this topic, I have to say that I know I haven't posted a video in quite some time now, and I normally don't do videos like this or ever posted a video with my voice in it, but I just thought I'd give my thoughts on this situation and how I feel regarding Akira Toriyama. I just thought I'd post this because I was a really big fan of Dragon Ball. And even made some videos on Dragon Ball Legends. And I just haven't really been able to have the time for Dragon Ball Legends in the past few years. But anyways, we'll get back to that later. So if you may or may not know, the Dragon Ball creator, Akira Toriyama, has passed at the age of 68. On March 1st, 2024, when I first seen this, it made me just want to not believe it. I didn't want to believe it, but ended up being true. So now I just want to speak on what Dragon Ball meant for me growing up and how much impact it had for me through many things in my life. Dragon Ball was one of my first ever animes I got into by myself. I don't quite remember the exact first time I got introduced to it, but I remember being at my grandparents' house, staying up just to watch it, even though I had a curfew. I even took a VHS tape of the Broly movie, the first one, from a Blockbuster that I still have to this day, probably like in my shed somewhere. That was my first Dragon Ball movie from what I remember, and I might have watched it more than like 50 times, I swear. I never actually got the chance to get into the OG Dragon Ball, but I have actually seen maybe a few episodes and maybe some clips here and there, but not fully watching it through the whole series, so I'll definitely get into that. My Dragon Ball journey started on Dragon Ball Z Kai, and after that I just had so much love for the franchise ever since. Also, I remember playing the games back then on like PS2, PS3, PSP, etc. Although some were well made, I would still play them and have fun with them. Like back in like elementary, middle school, I would go over to my cousin's apartment. Well, technically he's like my uncle, but we were around the same age, so I call him cousin since he calls me that as well. Or should I just say Kunko? I don't know. But yeah, so I would go to my Kunko's house. apartment I'm at, and I would go over to play Budokai Tenkaichi 3 almost all the time after school. We'd even have a few friends over sometimes, and we'd have like a little tournament between all of us. The memories, man. We would just be playing as kids, just having the time of our lives. I remember going over there too, and we would like draw the Dragon Ball characters, and that's just the memories. But yeah, I also remember like when my parents had got me a game for Christmas, and I knew it was Budokai because I peeked through the wraps and I saw that it is a Dragon Ball game. And you know, as a kid, you just get so excited for stuff like that. But yeah, I would be on that game all the time. Then I just got, after that, I just got like all the other Dragon Ball games. Well, not all of it, but some of the Dragon Ball games after that. Just because I loved the game. I would get like, I had like Budokai Tenkaichi 2, Dragon Ball Infinite World, Dragon Ball Sagas, even though that game wasn't really all that. Battle of Z as well. I know a lot of people didn't like that game, but I just still found a way to enjoy it because that's how much I love the franchise and just Dragon Ball. But yeah. Well, I won't yap for like too long. So I just want to say I appreciate you, Toriyama, for just the way you changed the culture of anime. And excuse me. And shaped it to what it is. Without you, anime wouldn't have most likely been this popular like it is today. So thank you. Your legacy will continue to live on through your work. Your family, friends, and even fans. Can't wait for more Dragon Ball content soon and beyond that. I also wanted to talk about the channel and where I would go moving forward, but I'm not sure if I'll get back to Legend. Since I'm so out of the loop and the skill gap just seems too far. Who knows? Maybe I'll come back to it. I'll discuss it next time. But we'll get back to that whenever I do make a video on it or whatever. Yes. I just love Dragon Ball so much, and it was a big part of my life, and then to many others as well. So I know how you guys are feeling. You guys know how I'm feeling about this. Like, it got me through so much things as a kid, as a teenager, and still even as an adult. Like, I remember when I would get mad, like, you would just like have that moment to yourself, like, you would go into like your room or something and just pretend you're going like Super Saiyan or something. I don't know. But yeah. That's really all I needed to talk about and just share how much Dragon Ball meant for me. And I know other people are posting the same about how they feel about this whole thing. And I just wanted to say how much I felt them and how crazy it is that this thing actually happened. But yeah, that's all I need to say. I'll catch you guys later whenever I do come back. Thanks to you all for, you know, watching my videos, subscribing, and everything. And thank you to Akira for blessing my childhood and adulthood with a great series in Dragon Ball. Rest in peace to a freaking legend, man. You inspired many people. many lives just through the work of your arts and gave people something to run to whenever they need to get out of reality. This is a lot. This is a lot to take in right now. But I'm sure he's in a better place now. Yeah. I'm just looking forward to more Dragon Ball. So yeah, I'll catch you guys later. Bye now. Rest in peace, Toriyama.